research is finally catching up with what many people in the early childhood profession have known for years. Actually, I've been asked, why have you kept this a secret for so long? We knew the effects of working with young children between the ages of 0 to 5 had lifelong lasting effects. What's happening is the potential for a future adult to be able to learn, all of that brain development occurs actually before the age of 3. We're not talking about calculus and algebra. We're talking about the ability to learn. The human wiring of the brain, if you will, occurs before the age of 3 and 90% by the age of 5. And in order for those synapses, that brain wiring to take place, children need to have positive early learning experiences. They need to be read to, talked to. If that's not happening, then the brain wiring's not happening. And unlike a car or something that's not working, you can go and get it fixed. You can't do that with your brain, and you can't do that with children. So if children miss those opportunities and those experiences for the opportunity for the brain wiring to occur, it goes away. That the synapses, that opportunity is lost forever. And then the child shows up to school supposed to be able to be at the same level of ready for learning as everyone else, but they are not, and they will continue to struggle for the rest of their life.
As a parent, I didn't understand the importance of how important it was to read to my children and talk to my children. I didn't realize until just the last few years how important those first 5 years are in a child's life. And it is so important. And when we realize that there are many children in our communities that doesn't have anybody reading to them, doesn't have anybody talking to them, and all of those things, and they will start school 5 years behind, they will never catch up. That is a real sad statistic, and it is happening all over the country.
That's a real key entity in making our kids successful in life, is don't let them get behind. We want to keep them ahead of the curve instead of below. So it's exciting to see some of the things that we're trying to do to make a real impact in our community. And that's part of the B5. That's what we're trying to do.
The biggest thing is to maybe ask someone in the early childhood community, is there a coalition? Is there a collaborative group of people that are coming together talking about this important initiative? What a collaboration and a coalition will do is bring everyone to the table to find out what assets are there and then be able to work together. So if that isn't happening, that's the number one thing that needs to start happening. And then finding some baseline information about where your community is on this. Maybe you're gonna identify that your community has no high quality childcare options at all. Well, that needs to be number one priority. It's an economic development issue as well as an early childhood issue and having children be ready to go to kindergarten. So look and do a scan. What's happening in your community? Where are the gaps? And then how can we collectively come together to fill those gaps? Being a part of a child's life from 0 to 5 is the most important role that a parent has. Yes, when they go to elementary school, when they go to high school, you'll be making sure that they have done their homework and they are attending school and being there. But getting them to that point is actually the most important part. The schools, once they get there, they know what to do. They've got the curriculum in place, but the children have to have had the opportunity to be ready to be successful. And that's where the parents and the community can play the most important role.